One in five Californians live in rural areas. The people who live here suffer more chronic health conditions and have higher rates of hospitalization than those living in urban settings. The challenge is to improve their access to primary care and improve their health. Primary care physician Dr. Bob Hartman has been crisscrossing Amador County for 22 years, preventing illness and treating the sick and the injured. But his patients are not just names. Rather, they are his friends.
So maybe I'm doing all right. I think I am.
People would recognize my bug. There weren't very many lime green bugs in the county there, and they would like follow me into a gas station and ask me a medical question, or go, you know, see it parked outside the grocery store and go into the grocery store to find me to ask me something. And it's just another one of those little quirks of a small town.
We come down Broadway.
Whether it is a lunchtime jog through town with friends or shopping at the local grocery store, everybody knows the town's doctor.
That better be healthy food.
Hey, how you doing?
And if you're too ill to make it to the clinic, guess what? An old-fashioned home visit by the doctor is not out of the question. This day, Hartman is visiting 74-year-old Maria Baker, a longtime patient of his.
She's had significant heart problems. She has some other chronic medical problems, but then on top of that, pneumonia and then her poor husband passed away, so it's really been a difficult time for her. And hold it again.
This good-natured patient is deeply appreciative that Dr. Bob made the effort to come and see her.
It's just overwhelming. It's just wonderful.
A year ago, 88-year-old Frank Del Porto was driving his tractor when it rolled over. He was seriously injured. He says there's a big difference between city and country doctors.
Doctors in Folsom are the bigger ones. You see them for a minute or two whenever they come in there and do what they have to do. And I'm not objecting to what they do, but that's the last you see them. Dr. Bob Hartman and the rest of the doctors over here, you might run into them during the week. You see them often and, hi, how are you? And I think it's more family related kind of a thing.
The concern of many people around here is when Dr. Hartman retires, will someone take his place? Well, nationally, the challenge is that only 1 in 10 doctors choose to work in a rural community. As a result, the UC Davis health system is committed to increase those numbers. And the way they're doing it is that they're giving their students experience working in rural communities starting in their first year of medical school.
We have a doctor shortage of about 17,000 physicians in 5 years, and a large part of those are in rural areas. The population is growing, and we have a generation of physicians who are ready to retire, and the ones who do train disproportionately settle in urban areas.
Filty is directing a UC Davis health system program to help California's underserved communities. This initiative, called Rural Prime, stands for Programs in Medical Education, and it will produce hundreds of physician leaders who will help fill the state's need.
We know they do better out there if they're familiar with a rural setting. They grew up there, they've had training there, and that's probably the most important thing, and also having resilience.
The heart of the program is a connection between the rural physician and the student. This Amador physician has become an important link to third-year UC Davis medical student, Terza Cannon. The two of them are spending nearly 8 weeks together in all facets of primary care medicine.
What'd you hear?
I heard some bronchi on expiration over here and then increased breath sounds at the bases.
Yeah, for Jed, they really sounds pretty darn good.
Okay. Though.
Check over his right middle lobe also. It's very important for them to simply dive in and do what we do on a day-to-day basis to see the patients that we see, to go to the hospital, to go out and make home visits, and really get a sense of community, of what the community is like. We have a unique ability to do that. That can't be done in a university setting.
Students who volunteer to enroll in this program not only receive their medical degree, but they also get a master's in public health. That combination helps them become leaders and advocates for improving healthcare delivery in isolated communities.
One of the skills that I hope to take with me that I've learned from Dr. Hartman is how to really listen to your patients and how to give them your time in a way that you don't seem hurried, that you're interested in, that you're concerned.
Hartman, who is also Amador County's public health officer, often appears on the local public access station, talking about medical concerns that affect the community. On this day, Cannon joins him.
We are developing our flu vaccine clinic schedule at the health department, and that will start in early October.
The Rural Prime program allows Cannon to travel all over Amador County and work with other doctors. Here in Plymouth, she works with Dr. Catherine Ledger with a patient who needs knee surgery.
Then you grab the heel and you pull up and you just twist the heel over.
Ledger says working with these medical students has been encouraging.
They've been absolutely amazing, highly motivated, energetic. They've been actually really rejuvenating, I think, for the whole office.
There's a certain level of independence, I think, that is required of a physician in a rural area. Some creativity, a lot of working with what you have.
The UC Davis Prime program serves rural communities from King City to Reading. Dr. Tom Nesbitt, who specializes in rural medicine and the use of advanced technologies to improve access to medical care, says rural doctors need better tools.
What we're trying to do is to try and train the next generation of rural providers that have the best medical training possible, that are trained in the environment in a rural community, that they're likely, the type of community they're likely to practice in, and finally trained to have the skills and the knowledge that they're going to need to practice in this new digital age of medicine.
The UC Davis School of Medicine is selecting 12 students a year out of a first-year class of 100 to become rural doctors. Many of these students have come from rural backgrounds and have the resiliency to succeed.
You see a wide array of conditions, and that itself is challenging, so you have to keep up on everything. It's isolating, and one doesn't have the same number of supports as a physician. On the other hand, it's great because you're a community leader. So those are the challenges they have.
You can practice good medicine in a rural area. You don't need the specialists looking over your shoulders.
Dr. Martin, this is my son, Mike.
Hi, Mike.
How about you?
There are certain families where I take care of four generations of people. You go out to their house, you visit them, you learn so much more of the totality of what makes up their day-to-day activities, their day-to-day health problems, and their day-to-day socioeconomic problems, all of which blends into how do you really take care of them.
Is it painful up here?
No.
After another busy day, Cannon says her desire to serve a rural community as its physician is stronger than ever. Paul Fotenauer reporting from Davis.